they can put theirs on. I don't know where our legal observers are. They better show up.
Well, she's she's got her green hat. Nayara does.
Okay, so Nayara's doing legal observing. So let's get in. We got who's coming? To go.
We made to pile in quickly.
There's two here.
Come on. I mean, somebody can squeeze all the way back here.
Okay.
Well, we gotta move like now.
So, we need to go over the performance. This is what's gonna happen. We're gonna enter the water plant. We're gonna all lay down very quietly. Nakia's gonna give her speech. Then Nakia's gonna lay down. We're gonna be there for 20 minutes. Get up and silently leave.
Okay.
Who's the media? We've got Jake May and Brittany Grayson.
They're gonna meet us over there.
Brittany's in the front seat.
Oh, you're social media.
You're doing social media? Okay, I just wanted to check.
I can too, if you need to see, honey. I can silently tweet.
My phone gets fixed. I have it.
Sam and Denzel are gonna have our media stuff immediately, like it's after.
Cool.
Just to go over, a performance is not acting. When you are doing a performance, it means that your emotions are amplified, right? So we really wanna think about these issues. Think about our daughters, think about our bodies, and really harness that emotion. So just think of you're being yourself, but 100 times, right?
Yeah.
It's okay to cry.
You love it if you cry.
I'm like shaking. I'm so like, so did I tell you guys the story about my sweater today?
No, what's it say?
So this is a sweater from Ellen Lesbron. She's a pretty famous artist out in Portland, Oregon. And she knitted this sweater. It's a replica of an activist from the 80s who was protesting the missiles in Berkshire, England. And so she sent it to me, and it's supposed to bring me courage and power.
Oh,
very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, she also is a former professor of mine, and she taught body politics, so this is a good performance to be wearing in her sweater. Did you see the battle axe sweater?
Fall in the water.
No, I didn't fall in the water. I fall off of here.
You need an MRI?
Yeah.
If you keep falling over?
Yeah. That's what I told her. She may have like a slight concussion.
Anyway, I won't fall today. Hopefully, if I won't.
Okay,
so
the treatment plant operator says you guys got to get out of here. Are we leaving? I think we're gonna.
I told your family they had bail money ready.
So I think that
I would say
you guys need to make that decision now.
I would say I'm not gonna move until they tell me that the cops have been called.
Yeah,
okay.
Let's wait till they call the cops.
But so you guys need to make a decision on you know, like even though you do not want this to be an arrestable action, sometimes shit happens. So Hazaray said that she's not leaving until they say that you're calling the cops. So if the water
speaking of arrestable
or somebody
actions,
help you,
right?
Exactly. Yeah.
What?
It's not
pull
open
up, yeah, just
yet.
Pull up to the gate. No, we pull up to the gate.
Pull up to the gate.
Oh, okay. All right.
And then we
so
just wait.
Is the notebook back here?
Yeah. Okay. Should we put like, how many children we have? As mothers or no?
A follower.
You're not a follower.
Do I need to get out and use the call box?
Maybe back up and then pull closer.
Over on that side.
Oh, over on that side.
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Maybe they used to have the game closed.
And just anything, just say we'd like to come in, or just say I'd like to come in, please. And everything, you know, we need test bottles, which is the truth.
We need test bottles.
We need test bottles.
Now, do you want me to pop my head in the office?
That was easy.
And hey, we're getting to, and make sure, I'm going to grab some test bottles because I'm not going to make her run. Yeah.
Okay, here comes Jake.
Here's Jake. Where's Jake?
Jake's on foot.
He's on
foot. He better run. Tell him to run.
He's running. Yeah, he's
and
in.
You're going to go all the way around to the side. You're not going to go in the front. We cannot get in the front, okay? You're going to go all the way to the side. See where that black car is parked along the side of the building? That's where we're going to go. You cannot get in the front of the building. It is locked at all times. Reserved for water plant. Okay, so yeah, we can pull in here then maybe. So you always went in that side door back there.
Okay, 20 minutes.
20 minutes.
Does anybody want to be a timekeeper or is that going to be me?
Well, I've got 5 after 8.
Okay.
And they're on, the suits are under this seat here?
Yeah, and we have to open the back.
Oh, okay.
Okay, do we want to lay on the front yard with the water treatment plant or go inside? That is going to be up to you, honey.
Inside.
All right.
All right, here we go.
I'm going to pop my head in the office, say hi, let them know that we're all cool. Because, yeah. And if worse comes to worse, we can lay outside the gate and still get the water treatment plant in the background.
Okay.
And I gotta grab test bottles anyway.
Go ahead.
Hold on a second. It's nothing bad. lay on the grass. On the steps.
Trespassing on property that is protected under Homeland Security. individuals has been told multiple times that they are trespassing. And each individual has decided to remain on public property trespassing and not move. Each person has been instructed that charges will be filed against them because they are trespassing. When they were perfectly entitled to file an article of protest so that they could protest peacefully without the incident of trespassing. Again, these individuals that you see on this video are trespassing at the Flint Water Treatment Plant. There has been no contact physically made with any of these persons. There was no permission given to any of these persons to be on the Flint Water Treatment Plant property.
It's 7:18.
those who have deliberately trespassed onto public property without any regard for public health and the public service by trying to serve the public. Utterly disrespectful.
Protest I've ever been to.
Woo! That was so intense.
That was intense.
Yeah, it was.
It was a little cold. But
it was a little cold.
Felt like I was laying on
Nikia,
ice.
Nikia, you did such a good job.
You did great.
You
woman.
Were awesome.
You
did.
You kept talking.
Yeah, I know. Like, where's the kids, man?
They didn't give them to them?
No, they locked the doors.
They locked the doors. Those guys, when I was coming, I said, there's three coming behind me. They were like, yeah, they lied and said they wanted some test kits.
Well, no, we did. I do need test kits, but they locked the doors. They hear them? They locked the doors behind us.
Yep.
So.
How do you guys?
Now they're not going to let us out.
No, they. I think it automatically goes up.
They got to let him in.
Drive up to the gate.
How do you guys feel?
Cold, but good.
Good. Feel good?
I feel
kind of
bad.
Yeah, we didn't hurt anything. We didn't do anything wrong.
We
didn't even go in, man.
We didn't even
no.
get in.
This is
our...
Nikia was the only one that spoke.
Yeah, it's not theirs.
She kept shouting.
She kept saying we're on public property. It's like, what, you're contradicting yourself.
How can you trespass on public property is what yeah. I wanted to say.
I know.
You're on public property and you're trespassing.
I'm like, I'm very confused by what you're saying.
She's like, you could have got a permit to do a peaceful protest.
Like, this is the most peaceful one I've ever been to.
I don't think we're fighting anybody here.
No, this is completely peaceful. Yeah, we're dead. I thought it was great, to be honest with you.
None of us moved. Nobody.
And the funny part is she's like, if the Flint police won't, they seriously.
They wouldn't come.
And that's the thing.
So then she says, call the state police.
They are not going to come. Because they're probably like, what are they doing? Laying on the sidewalk.
Okay. Like, we're really going to stop getting drug dealers to come get these women off the steps.
Your experience
in the process? We were really peaceful. We laid down on the steps of the water plant, and it was really emotional. I'm still like jazzed up a little bit about it, but it was an incredible experience.
Hey, I just will let you know that yesterday I totally had a bird crap on my head, and apparently that's good luck.
That's good luck.
Yeah. So I'm like, are you kidding me? I was outside, and all of a sudden something hit me. I was like, what was that? And then I was like, oh! And then everybody's like, that's awesome. That's good luck. I'm like, I had a bird poop on me.
Already. All right. Hasn't even kicked off
there. I know. So, all right. So we're good.
So maybe we'll have good luck the rest of the week too. That was awesome.
He's up there.
Okay. Somebody called me.
Okay.
Yeah, he is.
We're in beast mode now.
That's right.
The rest of the week is in trouble.
That's right. This is a heck of a way to kick off. You guys, everybody did awesome. And way to go, by the way, the media and videographers and photographers
yeah.
for staying
so
strong.
Much.
Thank you guys.
You guys didn't run either. Good.
Thank you.
Do it.
I know.
Do it.
I've never been arrested for a weather, let alone like laying on a sidewalk.
I know you're going to the judge. So what were you doing?
Laying on the sidewalk. We weren't impeding traffic. We weren't blocking the entrance.
They let us in. We didn't jump the fence.
Yeah, and she's like, "You're not here by permission." I was like, "Actually, they let us in the gate." But I won't argue that, you know, at all. But all right.
Well, she said that we're interfering with her protecting the public health.
I'm like, you're doing a terrible job at that, ma'am.
I think you already failed on that.
Yeah.
He was like, I'm pretty sure you're yelling at a bunch of corpses.
Outside the plant.
I was like, yeah.
He was trespassing on public property.
My taxes and water bills pay for this. I own this part as much as I paid. My water bill is so high that, yeah.
Just this
van
alone.
I was trying to think, what would I do in that place? And I thought, I just sit and watch and see what happens.
Oh, you wouldn't have that.
You know, you wouldn't. Well, that's true.
The nerve of her. This is my plant. This is my community. Well, whose community is this?
This is your community.
Her hands just got here.
Yeah,
Yeah, she just got here. She just got here.
A month.
Lady,
like a month.
On the block.
Is she even
from? You probably don't even live in Flint, huh?
Yeah, I don't know if she does or not. We'd have to look it up.
No, let's find out.
She just started working here like a month ago.
Yeah, she just got hired a month ago.
But we're not in a perfect.
That's I don't know what happened to the...
I'm glad I had my head.
They took all your tweets down.
Let's post it now.
Taking your pictures. Where did you live tweet?
No, they, I didn't have to do it. I just went right
back. Look at the new ridiculous water
director.
So...
No, she's a plant supervisor.
I had that would make sense because she has no idea what the op
is. That's why I didn't like
it. Yeah, she's yelling, screaming at us. And taping us. I'm like,
oh, I'm glad that I brought my
all right, then. We're not doing anything to harm you. We're not stopping, like, your job.
And who is she asking their name?
The media.
I heard one of the media. Oh, okay.
Or anybody.
Or anybody.
No one has given me there.
Because we're dead. We're dead. We can't talk.
We can't talk.
Jeez.
This is peaceful.
This is so
disrespectful. She's like, you could have peacefully protesting. I'm like, this is the most peaceful I've ever protested. I have not said a word. I'm not moving. I'm like, I don't.
You could have filed for a permit. Right. Then it wouldn't have been fun,
after I got the permit.
Yeah, no doubt.
Say that one more time, Nakia, for the camera.
I died after I got through telling my story.
You totally held strong and told your story.
I saw her come lay down. I was like,
she's like, man, now I'm dying. I'm like, sweet.
We were able to catch everything.
And that's the funny thing is, like, I could understand if, I guess, if we'd went inside the plant, they could be more pissed, but we're sitting on steps outside.
Yeah, so how did
and with locked really... doors behind us, what are we hurting?
And you guys let us in the gate.
Yeah, so there's that.
She said we were risking public health.
Yeah. We're risking public health by laying on steps.
Mess up the water. I mean,
yeah, you guys are doing a fine job at that. You know? We're not going to do your jobs for you, we promise.
No.
I don't know. We could probably do a better job of it.
Yeah, this is true.
We could clean it up a little better naked.
Yeah.
Well, we actually care.
Yeah, then there's that. That's a good point. And she never even asked what we were doing. She just starts yelling and screaming.
I know.
Like, why are you guys doing this? That's what I would do. I'd be like, what are you guys doing? Why are you doing it? And then I just stood aside and be like, psh, do it. You know?
Later.
I mean, you're not, if you're not going to break anything, you're not going to hurt anything, you're not going to put anybody in danger, whatever, man.
She's just worried about her new job. She's looking stupid.
Yeah, she is. Well, now she looks worse. I just want to raise my hand and be like, I'm one of the residents of Hot Poison, so...
But she was well rehearsed. She kept saying over and over again.
She'd been told what to do.
Yes.
So she was doing it bigger.
Exactly.
I thought that she was doing it already. Maybe they got confused with
the... Woo-woo! Shout out to the drivers!
Yeah!
We got so much!
She should have had them meet us at the up there.
I know. Thank you for not leaving us.
Exactly.
It's been a long walk.
And poor, the police must have said we're not coming. Cause
she was so mad.
Well, call the state police then. We'll take them a while to get from Corona Road.
The police were like, well, probably like, what are they doing? That's it? We have actual crime to work on. So, you know.
Ladies, you have Amber Alerts.
Yeah, we, yeah.
How do you feel, Laura?
I feel really emotional, like my heart was like beating in my chest and I had to calm down and like I said, I was just thinking, you know, like just laying there, like kind of what I was thinking and it was so peaceful and then the flag flying overhead and I just
it was so
I got
intense.
So emotional, the blue sky,
the blue,
blue sky,
beautiful.
The flapping flag.
I'm calling the peace America's heartbreakers.
America. I love it. I love it.
And I was just thinking, like, laying there on the I tried to be as uncomfortable as possible to, you know, to make it look like a crime scene. And so, like,
and I had my arms all cocked weird and stuff.
Yeah, the step
then
was digging
my mouth
into my
wide
back.
Open, like,
sweet.
Rigor mortis.
Yeah. Yeah, and I just kept thinking, I died today.
Yeah.
I died today,
and they don't care.
And they don't care. I died 2 years ago.
And they don't care.
They don't care.
They just care about their image and their money. They do not care about us.
She's just worried about her image. Exactly.
Yep.
You can tell.
So nothing's changed.
Nope.
I was listening to Naira. Oh, yeah.
Francis, what happened to...
No, Nakia.
This is really the most peaceful thing I've been through.
And I had to
photographed, like, college riots where they're, like, burning couches over a basketball game. That's right. Like, this is nothing.
Just all these
thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, everybody.
I'll send you, unless I have your email, I'll send you some photos today.
Thank you, Brittany.
Thank you, everybody.
Facebook photos, Twitter photos.
Yeah.
So I tweeted pictures under Flint Rising. That's why I had to do social media support. So you can tag yourself. I still have like more pictures I need to upload. It was just
thank you. Oh, and then it's cold. I'm like, so
save
it was not hard.
A spa day.
You know, dang. You're like, we did good today.
Wonderful. And Eileen, so you drove the van for us.
Yes, I did.
So what was that experience like for you?
It was very different.
Okay.
But no, it wasn't nerve-wracking or anything.
Okay.
Everything was calm and peaceful. No problems at all.
Okay.
They spoke to me and I told them I had no comment.
Bye.
What did they say? Do you remember?
Yeah, they said, did you request the water sample bottles? I said, yes, I did. And then he said, well, what are the people in the suits? I said, well, I have no comment, but I do need the water testing kits. But they never brought them out.
Good for you. Thank you. You were just the right person for us to have today.
Thank you.
Do you want to say what organization that you are with?
I'm with Greater True Hope Christian Church. Our pastor is Reverend Edwin Anderson.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, thank you to
and
you.
Flint and Lives Matter.
Flint Lives Matter. Thank you to you and
you're
Pastor
welcome.
Anderson.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay. Workshops in January. I mean, this is something that we've been talking about for a while. And just people are finally at the point where they're just tired and nothing's happening, you know. So, seem like the right time to do it. There's going to be a week of action, so every day we're doing different actions.
This Friday's changed.
So I actually still have your card on my phone.
Hey, Desiree, so here's the plan.
We did that.
I'm going to have a Friday.